All right, folks, so we're gonna start the color phase of this. And I have picked out essentially all the colors that I need. I went off of the color pencil value scales that we did a long time ago, kind of in the beginning. So I picked out the colors based off of this one. And those should be the colors that we use to create this. Okay. So have this off to the side to reference. What you need to do is, if your pencil is really dark, take a kneaded eraser and lighten your drawing, because colored pencil and pencil do not mix very well. Double check your drawing one last time, because it's really important that you have it correct. Okay. Next thing you're going to do is I would start with a Parma Violet and start laying in just the dark sections there with little circles. It's a slow, methodical process, but should give you nice, smooth, and rich colors. So I'm just figuring out where the darks are, leaving gaps for where the lights may reside. And you can use Parma Violet to do pretty much mapping out of any, with any of the gummy bears that you pick. This is the color that you can use, and you can layer other colors over top of it. Just to basically get an understanding of where the values are. Continue to check proportions, shapes, placements of the whole thing, the body parts. This is a Tuscan red pencil that I'm using over the Parmaviolet to do the darks. Just a true blue. There's a bit of true blue in some of the shadows. Again, just little circles, trying to map out where everything is. some indigo blue. Start working into the shadows a bit more. You aren't going to use any black colored pencil. You're going to mix the colors to create a more vibrant, luminous color. Tuscan red. It's just regular orange. Leaving gaps where the shines, where the highlights might be. just building up slowly. Mm-hmm.